students of 8th standard, let us start from the page number 122, estimation in percentage. Now you can see your bill in shop is ₹577.80, and the shopkeeper gives a discount of 15%. How would you estimate the amount to be paid? So ₹577.80 is near to 580. So directly you can calculate the 15% of 580, or in other way, first 10% of it. So 580 into 10 upon 100, you will get ₹58, and then you will half of the for calculating the 5%. So 5%, what you will do, just divide by half in 58, so 29. So total 10% here and 5% here, so total you are getting ₹87 discount. So easily you can subtract, you could therefore reduce your bill amount by ₹87 or about 85. So this is also, you can take near to 80 or 90 or 85, which will be the approximately. Now try estimating 20% of the same bill amount. Try finding 15% of ₹375. So let us start. Now see, here is the ₹577.80 approximately near to ₹580. So 20% of 580 we can calculate easily. 580 into 20, or you can directly use by those what we have calculated. So ₹116, near to 120 also you can take. So when you will subtract 120 from it, I have a correct value, corrected value I have taken. So you can see here 464 or ₹462.60 he will pay. Now see here, the ₹375 approximately you can take ₹380, and 10% 15% discount is on this money. So first what you will do, according to the that example, 10% first you will calculate. So easily you can calculate ₹38, you can take near to 40 also approximately, okay. So, and when you will divide, you will take just a half of it, so 5% you will get. So 19 you can take, 20, so total 58 is there. So near to 60 you can take. You can see here 30 plus 20, so near to 60 you can take here. And then 380 minus 60 is equal to ₹320 he will pay. Now next you can see here, prices related to buying and selling, profit or loss. Okay, for the school fair mela, I am going to put a stall of lucky dips. I will charge ₹10 for one lucky dip, but I will buy items which are worth ₹5. So see here, that girl is telling, so you are making a profit of 100%. That means just double on it. So purchasing price is 5 and just double, so 100% profit is there. So no, I'll spend ₹3 on paper to wrap the gift and tape, so my expenditure is ₹8, 5 rupees here and 3 rupees here, so total 8. So I will earn 2 rupees profit on it. So on the 8, out of 8, 2 rupees profit, so 25% only she is earning. Sometimes when an article is bought, some additional expenses are made while buying or before selling it. These expenses have to be included in the cost price. Suppose that you have purchased a TV, a sofa set or a fridge, so you charge by rickshaw fellow or you are hiring any vehicle or transportation charges also, you can say that. So over you will pay, suppose that 200 is there, so you will 200 also you will add in this the selling price, because you have purchased in the cost price, because you have purchased, suppose that the price of washing machine you have purchased in 20,000 and when two overhead charges, that means whatever extra charges you are paying by rickshaw or any other transportation charges, you are paying 200. So the total price of washing machine will be 20,200 rupees. So this may include expenses like amount spent on repairs, labor charges, transportation, etc. Now example is here, but we will start example, you will solve yourself and find selling price. If a profit of 5% is made on this, this and this. Okay, let us start. Question number 1 and sub question A, B, C. Find selling price SP if a profit 5% is made on a cycle of rupees 700. The cost price of cycle is given rupees 700 and overhead charges rupees 50. In the question number B, the cost price of lawn mower bought at rupees, that means CP, rupees 1150, overhead charges rupees 50, and the cost price of a fan is equal to rupees 560 and overhead charges is rupees 40, and we have to calculate the selling price of each one. Okay, let us start. Now see here, cost price of product is given rupees 700 and the overhead charges is equal to rupees 50. Profit percentage 5%. So now see here, overhead charges, that means extra amount we paid on the product, and it may be whichever may. अगर आपका जो सेकंड फ्लोर पे आप रहते हैं तो उसका लाने का चार्जेस हो, या बाय रिक्शा आप अगर आप उस प्रोडक्ट को लाए हैं तो उसका चार्जेस हो. सो टोटल सीपी, बिकॉज वी ऑल्सो पेड दिस मनी, सो वी विल एड दिस मनी इन द सीपी. सो न्यू और टोटल सीपी यू कैन से, सो न्यू सीपी इज इक्वल टू सीपी प्लस ओवरहेड चार्जेस. सीपी प्रोडक्ट ऑफ सीपी इज 700 प्लस, so new CP is rupees 750. Now profit in rupees, profit is given in the percentage, so profit in rupees is equal to 5% of rupees 750. In place of OF of, you will put multiplication sign 750 into 5, and percentage sign when you will remove in the denominator you will put 100. So 0 cancel by this 0, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, and 75 divided by 2, that means rupees 37.50. So SP of product will be CP plus profit. So CP is 750, profit is 37.50. So total SP is, that means SP is rupees 787.50. Now sub question B, see here, cost price of lawn mower is given 1150, overhead charges is equal to rupees 50, profit percentage same in all the three questions. Now new CP will be CP plus overhead charges, so add this two value, you will get rupees 1200. Profit in rupees, 5% of 1200, when you will calculate this 1200 into 5, percentage sign you will remove, this 20 cancel by this, rupees 60. So CP plus profit is equal to 1200 plus 60, 1260. Now third question, cost price of fan is equal to rupees 560, overhead charges is equal to rupees 40, profit percentage same, CP plus OC, that means new CP, so 560 plus 40, 600. Now profit in rupees, 5% of 600, when you will calculate you will get rupees 30. You can see here, so SP is equal to CP plus profit, 600 plus 30, 630. Okay,